Hello everyone, I would like to welcome you all in the new semester and in my class of CIS 3158 Mobile Web Application and Game Development. This is the very first session, and in this session I will cover the module overview. I am Dr. Harimohan Pandey from the Department of Computer Science, and my email ID is given here. We'll start this session with an overview of this module. So as far as the overview of this module is concerned, I have classified the overview in three sections, 1, 2, and 3. So in the introduction of the module section, I will be covering three things. Number one is module handbook, blackboard, timetable for this module, and the assessment. So in the assessment, I will cover the courseworks given for this module. In the second section of the overview, we'll discuss various topics that I will cover in week-wise manner throughout the semester. Lastly, you can see practical sessions are given, and in the practical session, you will work on tutorial sessions. A URL is presented here, and you can use this URL to access the tutorial for this module. Next, we'll discuss the timetable for given for this module. So as far as the timetable is concerned, you can see first we'll discuss time duration given for this module. So the overall time given for this module is 3 hours. 1 hour is allocated for lecture, and you will be provided pre-recorded video lecture in each week. Then 2 hour session will be given for tutorial or practical session, and in this will be face-to-face session, and it is expected that you work on the tutorial in the lab. Next, day and time for this module is given. This module will be organized on Friday every week from 11, this will be AM, 11 AM to 1 PM. The practical session will be organized in room number THF01, that is in the game lab. Next, I have given how this module will be supported in this semester. Here, you can see all the teaching and learning material will be provided through Blackboard. If you have any question, then don't be silent. You can discuss your doubt in several ways. You can send me email. You can discuss your doubt during the seminar and tutorial session, during the face-to-face session on Friday from 11 AM to 11 AM to 1 PM. You can discuss your doubt during office hours or in drop-in session. In this semester, all the office hours and drop-in session will be supported online, using Microsoft Teams or Skype for Business. This is the room number where you can see my office. My name, you know my name, and this is my email ID, which you can use to send email. So these are the different ways how you can contact me for any doubts. If you have any doubt and you want to some clarification in this module, then these are the different ways you can reach to me. In the next slide, I have presented how you can use the Blackboard. So I have highlighted three key areas on the Blackboard. This is the first key area, that is Home Hub. This one is the second one, that is Learning. And the third one is Assessment. Using the Home Hub, you can get the general information about the module. For example, you can get handbook, you can get your, you can see your attendance, you can see the tutor contact detail or any other details. Under the learning section, learning area of the Blackboard, you can access all the video lectures, presentation slides, and other guidance related to tutorial or lectures. In the assessment area, you can see the detail about the course works. So you can find here, you can get handbook. So a handbook for the coursework. Under the assessment area, you can get coursework specification. You can get the drop-in dropbox for coursework submission, for submitting coursework. Under assessment areas, you can see the deadline for the coursework. So all in all, you are going to use these three key areas on the Blackboard in this module. The next slide is given for the module overview. So here I have presented a brief review of this module. In this module, you will be learning both theoretical concepts and practical concept, that is coding, for web-based game development, and then you will convert your game and you will deploy your web-based game on the mobile devices. You will be incorporating various artificial intelligence methodologies during the game development to optimize the game and to integrate intelligence in the game. So what you have to do, you will first start theories, then you will implement the code during the tutorial session. Initially, you will develop web-based application, then you will convert, you will deploy your application on the mobile devices, and then you need to incorporate artificial intelligence methodologies to optimize the working of the game. The next slide is given to explain the goal for this module. So here you can see the goal is divided as theoretical goal and practical goal. As far as theoretical goals are concerned, you will learn different technologies, you will be using algorithm, you will learn artificial intelligence and heuristic based approaches for the web-based game development, web-based and mobile application development. And in practical session, you will use JavaScript programming, and you will use different technologies like Ember.js for static web application development, for dynamic web application development. You will use Create.js, Cordova you will use for deploying the application. In the mobile devices. And then you will apply heuristic approaches. You will use some searching based technique and optimization technique for optimizing your application. So here, what you are going to do, you are going to apply some artificial intelligence based technique to integrate intelligence in your application. In the next slide, I have given the outline of topics in a week-wise manner. So in week number one, we'll discuss static application development using Ember.js. In week number two, we'll discuss dynamic application development using Ember.js. In week number third, we'll discuss how to create user interface. Week number four is dedicated for working with SLJS for this interface. Then we'll use SLJS again for adding animation and audio on your application. Then in week number six, you will work on Apache Cordova and you will deploy this interface in your mobile device. Then in week number 7, you will be deploying the web-based application to your mobile device using Apache Cordova. Then you will use artificial intelligence and heuristic approaches for optimizing your application. In week number 9, we'll see how tree and search tree works and how we will use these two for the game development. Week number 10 is dedicated for Minimax search for the game development. So Minimax search is one of the algorithm for one of the searching algorithm, and we'll use this searching algorithm for the game development. In week number 11, you will work on alpha beta printing, and week number 12 will discuss coursework 2, and you will submit your coursework 2 in week number 12. The structure for this module is explained in the next slide. So as far as the structure for the session is concerned, so 3-hour session is divided as, in the first half an hour in each week, we'll discuss the feedback on the portfolio task. So each week you will be given a coursework, and you will complete the task. And in the upcoming week, in the next week, we'll discuss the feedback, and I will share the grade and feedback on your task. As far as the lecture is concerned, 1-hour lecture will be there, and we will use online pre-recorded lectures, and I will share this online pre-recorded lecture through Blackboard. And the agenda, the reason of sharing the lecture is to cover theories, ideas, and concepts for the module. During the tutorial session will be 2-hour tutorial session. It will be organized on Friday. Here you will work on practical exercises, and at the end of each week, you will work on portfolio task. That's all in this session. Thank you very much. Happy learning. In the next session, I will explain coursework given for this module.